Welcome to tonight's concert. Thank you for being here. We're grateful to be able to have a winter concert when it's 60 degrees. So thank you for coming in tonight, and then hopefully you'll enjoy the rest of the evening. They're doing just a great job. I've loved working with freshman band. You see, it's a smaller group maybe than what we're used to, but these guys started with us back in the days of COVID. So we were all a little bit nervous about how that was going to play out. Instrumentalists, you know, blowing spit everywhere and germs. But these guys all stuck with it, and I'm so glad that they're here and still playing. That first song you heard was Pink Lemonade, and it was originally written for banjo, so that's kind of fun. And then it was rewritten for band, and it makes a lovely march. Now this next song that we're going to perform for you is just too beautiful for words. Different folk tunes, including the Queensland Rover, Click Go the Shears, something I can't pronounce, and With My Swag Upon My Shoulder, and Kookaburra.
Thank you.
right. Well, we're zipping right through these. We have one more for you, and that is going to be Falcon Fanfare by Brian Bobbages here shortly. But first, I would like to thank a few people. For one, I already thanked the band as a general thing, because they're just awesome. So thank you, Freshman Band, for being so awesome. And we do have a few extras up there. You'll see Mr. Lorenz standing over there playing a few things for us, helping us out, having some fun. We get to play, so it's kind of fun when we get to play. So we enjoy that too, not just directing. We have our senior assistant back there, Nick Bunch. Yeah. He's helping us out. And then we have a few special guests sitting in with us. Over on clarinet, we have the twins, Sarah and Sydney. So thank you, Sarah and Sydney. And over here on tuba, we have Darian on box. So we thank you for coming. All right. Also, I do want to thank real quick before we play our final tune. I want to thank our setup crew. We had a lot of great help this morning. Kaylee Bruno, Elijah Getting, Cohen Tribbiano, Kaden Moreland, Chase Parks, and Bryson Ryan. And we also had Jackson Bauman help us out with some lights. So thank you guys for helping up with setup crew this morning. That was great. And after we play this tune, we'll flip around and have concert band come up on stage and we'll keep the concert going. But here is Falcon Fanfare by Brian Bobbages. Thank you.
All right, good evening. That first song was the Greyhound March. And it's got a little bit of local history, as it happens. It was written by Madison's grandfather, Dr. Robert Gregg, back in 1952. It's called the Greyhound March because he went to school in Union City, Tennessee, and the Greyhounds were a Cardinal farm team down there. It was first played that season for their opening game, and then not played again until 1992 here in Crystal City. So, it's an interesting little local flavor for a march. We don't get those very often. The next thing we've got for you, this is a Brian Balmage's tune called Rippling Watercolors. I'll read just a little bit of what he wrote in his program notes. The idea for this piece came from a simple set of watercolors. When children get a hold of these and use their imagination, the most amazing things can happen. Children can see things that adults never see. They open our minds while we help them grow and learn. So it's a very beautiful lyrical piece called Rippling Watercolors. right. Next up, we have one. I have this hobby. I like to go to the oldest parts of our library, which is a fantastic concert band library, and just pull stuff that I've never heard of and I can't find any recordings of, and then we try it. And sometimes we miss, but this time we did not miss. Although I can't find any information other than Leetonia is a city in Ohio. It has 1,816 people as of the 2020 census. And this piece was written in 1957 by Harold Walters. This is called Leetonia.
Thank you.
I'd like to make one special shout out. We had a last minute absence. Ms. Sikelski's helping us out in the trumpet section. She's hiding. Thanks, Ms. Sikelski, for that. And the last tune we've got for concert band is called Reverberations. We didn't plan on picking two Brian Balmage's tunes, but everything in the folder, this is what we liked for a program, so Brian Balmage is doing good work. He writes, based entirely on a two-note motif, which is an interval of a minor third, Reverberations explores the concept of sound as it echoes throughout the ensemble. The piece opens and closes with the same two pitches, which appear throughout the work, while timbres and harmonies constantly change and evolve. What that basically means is the theme of this is doo-doo. And there's more stuff going on too. After this last one, give us just a moment to switch over to the symphonic end. This is Reverberations.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, that was Solid Men to the Front, one of Sousa's marches. It's not one of his more popular ones, but according to critics and stuff, it's actually one of his better ones, and we enjoy playing it, for sure. The next piece, Dusk. This will take us on an auditory journey through what sunset might look like on any given day, whether it be beautiful, whether it be kind of dark and gloomy. We have some hopefully very beautiful moments that you can enjoy. So here is Dusk by Stephen Bryant.
Thank you.
Has been just a hoot to work up. We've had a great time with it. It's called Nemesis by Gary Zeke. Right, could be making that up. The Nemesis is battling your arch enemy. And in this case, it sounds like you're doing that, but there's a few dance moves thrown in for fun. I don't know, that's just what I did from it. So, make of it what you will. Here is Nemesis.
Thank you.
Sometimes it's just fun to play. That's what matters. Okay. Hey, thanks again for coming out tonight. Okay, hold on. All right, our next concert is March 19th, and that's going to feature our contest selections that we'll take to Mr. Clark Ensemble Contest at the beginning of April. Now, hopefully there'll be some extra little special performance surprises as well. We're going to finish with a song called Morning Madness. Some of us just aren't morning people.
Thank you.
probably not be a thing if all car horns actually sounded like the bicycle horn. And how many people in this band can now say that they know how to play the hairdryer in the band? Hey, thanks again for coming out tonight. We have a little bit of cleanup to do. The crew knows what to do, so hopefully they're going to come up and help us. And we'll see you next time. Have a great rest of the evening, and we'll see you soon.